gang, it's Mike from the Reuben Memoirs. I'm up here in the Great White North. Yes, Reuben Memoirs are going international. We are in Canada, in Windsor specifically. And someone let me know that this restaurant behind me, Nooch, never heard of Nooch before, but Nooch serves a vegan Reuben. You heard right, folks. Reuben Memoirs going international, and now we're going vegan. Could it be true? Apparently it is. We're going to get into all the details. I myself, I'm shocked. Like, I'm in Canada. I'm looking for the moose and the tundra, and it kind of looks like Metro Detroit, but hopefully the Reuben in here is as good, if not better, than anything else I've ever had before. I'll give you all the details soon. We're out.
I run the Reuben Memoirs. It's kind of a big deal. Dozens of followers. Tons of them. Perfect. So this could be a mutual coexistence here.
Sure.
I just see Reuben sandwiches and then I heard Nooch. Am I pronouncing it properly? So you guys have a vegan Reuben. Uncharted territory. Is it really? Well, I'm ordering it straight up. I'm going to do a full Reuben breakdown here for the Reuben Memoirs.
It comes from a side fries, do you have side and bacon fries? Or
you know what?
Poutine, since you're in Canada.
Poutine.
Right.
Yes, please. If I'm in Canada, we're going
to
do it right.
Okay, gang, it's Mike from the Reuben Memoirs, and we are live here in Windsor, Ontario, Canada, at Nooch's, a vegan restaurant, for the very first vegan Reuben Memoirs review. This is uncharted territory, groundbreaking landmark event, and I tell you what, this little restaurant here, In Windsor, you know what? You look at the details on the YouTube channel to get the address and the phone number and the times, all of that fun stuff. But they knocked it out of the park. Like, I didn't know what to expect. I went vegan in January. At least I tried to do it the best I could, and I survived, right? I wasn't sure if I could, but what I found is, you know what? There are a lot of great vegan options out there. I don't know, as Mary explained to me, vegan is more of a lifestyle. It's a whole embodiment about how they view animals. And there's other people who choose to eat vegan diet, which is just fine too. I'm not opposed to either of them, but I'd be lying to you if I said I'm a vegan. And certainly not. I eat way too much meat. I wear way too much leather at times that you could never consider me that. But what I can say is I'm open-minded to try anything once, usually twice, if you twist my arm or just wink, you know, I'm ready to go for most things. But this, getting to the task at hand, this vegan Reuben, I'm not even going to call it a vegan Reuben, I'm going to call it a Reuben sandwich. This is very good, very, very good. The flavor is phenomenal. They piled it high with, I don't know how they classify their corned beef. It's not corned beef, obviously, but it's a vegan product that it tastes just like it. The texture is there, the layers are there, the sauerkraut's phenomenal. That grilled, marbleized rye, nice and hot, nice and dry, no fennel seeds throughout. The cheese, according to the menu, is provolone. Now, I prefer Swiss. That would be the only knock that I'd have, because I think Swiss brings in an element, a different flavor that's a little bit stronger than provolone, and you can pick that up. And I'd say that's the one thing missing in this sandwich. This is a very, very good sandwich. Something to be proud of here up in Ontario, Canada, without a doubt. But this was a winner. I totally enjoyed it. I'm giving it 4.4 out of 5 stars. Like, it is up there. Total surprise. Wasn't expecting to give that sort of report. The poutine that I have here, as you can see, I'm damaging it real good. Just a classic flavor combination. Very savory. And here at Nooch's, they hit it out of the park. Like, the fries are nice and hot. They're crunchy. They've got the brown gravy. They got the cheese on top of it. They have the scallions, just phenomenal. Phenomenal meal and choice here. We're gonna top it all off by washing it down with the Flywheel Blonde from the Kent Brothers Brewery, which is also local up here in Ontario, Canada. Hold on one second, I'll get my reading glasses on, because this is right in Kent County, hence the name, the Sons of Kent Brewery. But the Flywheel Blonde, wonderful choice to wash all of this deliciousness down and clean the palate. it's great. You know what? We're making Reubens great again. You guys know it. That's why you tune into this all the time. And it's neat to see all the different variants and options. And I like what Mary said. Well, have you ever had a Reuben that wasn't great? Well, yeah, I have, unfortunately. But this isn't one of them. This one's phenomenal. Shout out to the new subscribers. I know that a buddy of mine, Scott Ives, is a new subscriber. Glad that you're tuning in and watching this. Dale Marcus, another subscriber, he heard about this and has been sharing it. And, you know, the passion for Reubens transcends all classes and all working types and all educational backgrounds. It is the bridge that builds a common bond, even between nations now. This is an international border that I crossed, and they've got great Reubens up here in Windsor, Ontario, Canada. Just super thrilled to be here. We are the Reuben Memoirs. We are making Reubens great again. Hashtag Virga. Don't forget to like, subscribe, share, and tell a friend, because we are on the prowl. We are looking to find out the best Reuben sandwiches near you so we can do this full detailed breakdown. And we'll talk to you in the near future. We are out.